Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to this week's channel update. This is this week's update number, let's see, I'd say probably about 620, I think we're at now, and we've been going for a while. So this is going to be letting you know what has gone on this past week between the series on the channel and a little insight to some of the things that have happened. Last week, it was the stream week where I work on the Block World City along with a few other friends, and that seemed to go pretty well. But in the prep work for that, there was a little bit of a mishap, which we'll get into that here in a second. But there's also more this week. Right after this program, we have Deal or No Deal, hosted by Bitten Spider and Tandarine. And we had the lovely contestant of Monty on the show. Looks like it's going to be a good episode. We also have coming up this weekend an episode of BeamNG Roadkill Projects, where the long-awaited project car of the cop car returns. Yeah, there's a lot going on this week. There's also Friday night game night going on. That runs on Fridays, like as usual, from 7 p.m. Eastern until about 11, but I think this week it's going to run a little bit longer. But let's show you a little bit of the mishap that I got into on the Nebula server. Me and my fellow Nebula friend Kleb got into a bit of trouble trying to lead a charge creeper over to my city. And yeah, it was a bit of a chaotic session. A few other friends were there as well. And it went just like this.
Jahambi at spawn. If you die to it, it's your fault. Something. I forgot the word.
Jahambi, okay, but Jahambi has a warning on the front
yeah,
door.
So it's their fault. Let the warning be the name tag on the creeper.
Dude, what, I would Shrek? Love to kill. I would love to kill someone with a charge creeper.
Can somebody put in chat, don't go to the marketplace portal? Or just don't go to the nether hub in general? High explosives inbound.
This is a really terrible idea.
Listen, really it's gonna work. I didn't know there were trapdoors behind the portal. Who the fuck did this?
We had a pump.
Okay, he's through the portal. Now time to go to spawn.
Oh no. This is...
Okay, the thing about this face is that... Don't you need to have... If you're gonna do this, don't you need to have two portals... in...
No, it's okay. I do have two portals at my base now, actually. That's a good point. I got my base and then the one that I set up last night. So this is going to work perfectly.
Club's going into the nether.
Perfectly, you say.
Listen, this is just as flawless as the spawn wars.
Oh my gosh, it was like right next to me when I loaded in. That was... Oh, some warning next time would be...
Oh no, 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 no!
Can you please...
Hey, Cass.
Can you please Hi. Record this?
I am.
I don't know why
I am.
Or you're recording
okay. Can you help me? You wanna look at this
sure.
for me? See if this makes sense?
Yeah.
That's my plan. Oh shit, it didn't hold. Hold on.
Oh fuck, I didn't think this through.
Wait, can it not go on the slabs?
Oh. I'll make this. Oh.
I don't have a place to put
it's
this
a Discord
thing.
Fucking long ass message. That's what I've come up with so far for assignments.
Oh my goodness.
You were okay, that looked really close. From Klez's perspective, it looks like you're like a block in front of it.
Well, yeah. You can't really see from this angle how far he is from it.
Oh, you face, don't you need to get across the tracks too?
That's okay. That's okay.
He can just break end rods.
Listen, I have pulled off many stupid things, and this was the stupid thing that I was looking to do at 1 in the morning.
It's gonna fucking explode, and you're gonna be really sad.
Listen, it's either gonna blow up my tunnel at my base. Why the fuck is there a skeleton
get
here?
Over it.
Oh, it
can, get over.
It's over, by the way.
Alright, hold on, I had to clear the rail off.
Whoa. Watch out, dude.
Oh! Oh no. Sorry, I gotta take his neck. Come on. Oh fuck, I fell.
Oh, I just want to double check.
It's gonna get everyone.
Old Shopping District 2 and
yeah,
MCP.
Way far away.
MCP. MPC 3. Come You're on. Gonna check them or I should check?
Come on.
No, I just want to double Come check on. Them as in.
Okay.
Like people running them as in.
So that'd be like the perfect thing to do with Luis, and he would just explode.
Is Old Shopping District 2, is that necessarily needing two people? I understand like why it could. I just want to double check that.
Wait, what?
Are you fucking kidding me?
He can't
Old
get up.
Shopping
he can't
District
get
2.
Up because of the trapdoors.
Yeah, what about it?
I just want to double check with that and mark to play Central 3.
Old Shopping Wait. District 2 is like Cheesy's Fishtopia and all of Swords, Old Shops, and the tunnel.
Okay.
I think that's
this is hilarious.
What was MCP again? I know it was like a bug MCP
here.
One.
Hold on. I forgot that I have.
Because you put 1 in.
Okay, I'm
MPC
way
3.
Far away.
And that is 8 shops, but again, if it's like smaller shops, then
I compiled that too. Well,
nice.
That portal
nice.
Has no blocks behind
that
it.
Helps?
It's okay. It's okay.
It.
Yeah. Is Atlantis still a shop? I wasn't sure if it's down or not. I just wanted to double check.
Yeah.
And it made sense I put bedrock breaking into
fuck.
Old Chopping District, correct?
Yeah, I saw your note on that because it's
yeah.
facing in that direction. I would have.
And I didn't want.
Oh my.
number Derek, one of Central to get too big.
Yes!
Yeah.
Okay, now I need to get a name tag and a place to put this guy.
Isn't he already name tagged?
No.
Yeah, it is.
Wait, is
yeah,
it?
It is. Yeah, they were all named Shrek.
I see why you have just one person on Central
creeper.
3.
I'm not even kidding.
Is that going
Did
to
I
be enough
this?
For that area? Or do you think that you should maybe add one more?
You should be fine.
Yeah, the portal I went through is my base.
So I only put 1 on that one because there's a small number of shops and they're not very big shops, really.
Like one's banners, one's maps.
Farm.
Yeah, I mean.
Wasn't it Zeph?
For what? Who has it currently?
Central 3?
Yeah, I put Zeph on that
one. Follow me, Kleb.
Because he doesn't own Banner Emporium, but he does have a subsection where he does
do
some business
in there. Do you know where the TARDIS is?
Oh, does he? I didn't know that.
Yeah, go behind the TARDIS.
No.
Okay.
It's like,
right,
it's not
right,
mainly his
right.
shop, like, he's not...
Yeah, that
one. Oh.
He basically has some banners there, like that. It's like an artist has, like, their friend artist in their shop a little bit, if that makes sense.
Right, yeah, no, I
get
it.
It's not his main business. Like, I'm the one covering for Soldarius while he's gone here and there.
Wait, behind the TARDIS?
But he does sell some stuff in that shop.
The long water pathway?
Right.
Oh,
I forgot you were covering for him, too, because
I
should probably not put you in there. Oh, wait, I already have you on there. Okay, good.
What are you putting in here?
I just wanted to double check.
Where are you
going to
put it?
You'll see.
Oh, yeah, in Minecraft chat. Zeph was like, what Kat said. I just want to double check with that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
At first, that wasn't, like, my first concern, because I forgot it was, like, Bandar Emporium was in that area.
Yeah.
But, I mean, concern was, like, the amount of shops.
If I can move around other people, if I can't move him around, because
it's not the worst.
But, yeah, exactly.
I see why you only have, like, very few, because maps, Kleb, banners, and yes, the horse shop,
block
very understandable.
In.
Armory basically does nothing.
Get on this
I
side.
I understand why there's one person. Not looking at it.
With the
and just
ones,
be ready to block
like,
him in.
Especially with the central ones. If I think there's only one central one that I only have
guess
one staff on.
Yeah. I mean, most of the central ones were planned to be maybe two. Rather than
I
the
might...
other ones.
I put
you
two
idiot.
In outskirts four because I expect that to continue growing.
Yeah, because there's a lot of growth there right now, but a lot of them are empty.
Yeah, well, there's two big ones that are in the progress, or three big ones, because are Jewish. Just put one there. And then now I apparently need to sell Clear Skies Cafe.
Okay, that thing needs to be longer. I'm making it longer.
Oh, the blue cyan? Not blue cyan, blue...
Oh no, oh no, Clip. Oh.
Yeah.
Don't scare me like that.
I don't know what they were thinking, because you have to access the back to get some of the items.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. I went in there, I'm like, which side is the shop?
Like, you have to go into the kitchen. I, like, bought some pumpkin from them, and it's like... I can't reach.
Yeah.
I was like trying to use the ender chest, and I was like, oh.
What are you doing?
Face.
What are you doing?
Face, you're fucking this up.
I think Zeph might be the only person I need to meet.
Kleb is
oh
too scared.
God.
Of everything that's
not,
could be, he's
I wonder why.
Because he's got ownership of the shop. It just works somewhat with it.
That's not the one I wanted to. Alright, fine. I'll sit right here, okay?
I'm also, like, trying to pair the people that consistently need reminders every right, week
now...
with people that don't.
No vision.
I
so
need
it doesn't blow up, okay? No vision
yeah,
allowed.
Yeah, but if I at you, you'll eventually see it and be like, oh yeah. Or if I at staff, not you specifically. I feel like. I don't
either
know.
Way.
Maybe not. I've never
so
had
happy.
To specifically talk to you.
I'm so
yeah, you
happy.
Have. Not,
have
like,
I?
Intensely.
Well, it hasn't been a while, then, has it?
Because fire needles was added
look
to my district.
Face.
Oh, yeah. That's why. That's...
Now look at all the fun that we had right there. Looked a little bleak for a moment, and I can't believe it. But Matt didn't have any faith in me to move that creeper. But over the years of playing Minecraft, I have proven that I am the master at moving mobs. So, that's not the only little bit of trouble that me and Kleb have gotten into this week. But we had a bit of a reach out from another server member, Emu King. You know, another bird brethren of mine. And he had a bit of interesting news to give the Kleb, which I don't think he was really expecting. You know, I know the whole joke of him having the better Kleb name and everything going on recently. And, well, still, I don't really understand it at all. But, you know, Kleb decided to bring me along. You know, just in case if anything kind of turned haywire, and it seems like we got ourselves a bit of a court case going down. So, yeah, things are going to get very, very interesting tomorrow. So stay tuned for that program. And right now, here's the little bit of trouble that Kleb has gotten into this week.
You're being summoned. The court.
Someone for what?
You stole my name.
Excuse me?
Yeah. You stole my name. All right, see you then.
Face, I can't believe this is an outrage. You have to help me, please. Help, help, I need help. Get me out of here. Help. I'm in danger.
Okay. Calm down. Oh. Okay. Well, Club's dead. Hoot boy. Looks like it's going to be a bit of an interesting one tomorrow, everybody. And it looks like we got ourselves a little bit more of a court case on our hands. But we'll see how all of that works out once it gets sorted. All right. Coming up next, we're going to go on a short commercial break, but then we are going to go over the little bit of progress that has happened at Block World City and then give you a little bit of insight to some of the changes that were made to the cop car and BeamNG. So we'll be right back after these commercial messages. All right, everybody, welcome back. Hope you enjoyed your short little break from our lovely little show here. And it's time to get a little bit more in-depth with the show here tonight, because this episode is very special. Because we are right now on the Pimp My Ranch set, where seasons 1 and 2 were recorded. We were graciously given the rights to film here today. And we're outside of the studio for the first time in a little bit, but we'll be back there next episode, hopefully. But it has been nice. Fun and cozy getting to sit here. Nice fireplace out here in the mesa. This quaint and cozy little ranch right here. It's always a fun little place to stay. But now it's time to get into a little bit of building updates from Block World City, which is aimed to open, hopefully, the end of this month. So, we're going to take you right on over there, and maybe even show you a sneak peek of our future headquarters and studio that is going to be... Alright, everybody. Here we are with our little Block World City update. And there's progress. Yes, tons of progress. Tons and tons of progress. So Stream Week didn't exactly go as intended, unfortunately. We had a lot of technical difficulties with my internet, but those are all solved now, and we still did a little Stream Week. Probably going to do more in the future. But the bar is complete, and I am very, very happy with this bar. Of course, the interior isn't done yet at all, and I'm going to get a few more buildings before I start to focus on that in. But, yeah, the bar is pretty much completed for the exterior. It's all sealed in except for a door on the roof. We're starting to get some other things planned out. I think right over there is where the scenic overlook is going to go. It should be on Main Street, and it's going to be the tallest building next to the TARDIS. It's probably going to be half the size. So, yeah, but there's going to be some office spaces in there, a studio or two, potentially. Potentially a studio or two. Not sure about that yet. But, yeah. Oh, I think the last thing we did was kind of show off the town hall. This is what I wanted to get done before stream week. And, yeah. I'm liking this place. It's not done yet. I want to put a little bit more detail into the walls, maybe a little bit more color, get some flower pots in here, but should be almost done. It's not a lot of work. I got a lot of leftover bricks from building this place. Ooh, it is nighttime. But what I have started to work on is the train station. And there's a little bit of a meme coming from it that me and Joseph have had from the planning the city. But, and there we go. So we kind of had a funny idea that in one of the tunnels somewhere to put a Subway, like the food chain restaurant, like a Subway inside of the Subway. And we're technically getting that, but basically, I'm building a train station kind of big enough to where, you know, you can head down the stairs if you need to, you know, travel over to the other areas, of course, once this place opens up. And, yeah, but up here, as a joke, and we are going to have bread that sells out of it, we are... We're going to put a Subway. There's going to be different names of bread and everything in here. Maybe the return of the Viagra bread. Or what the fuck? I think baguettes, I think they have on the server. Nerd has a bunch of them in one of his shops. But yeah, maybe we'll have a return of the baguettes. Then there'll be like a little eating area and a back door and everything into the alley. So yeah, we're getting that little bit of an Easter egg going. But, yeah, next video should be me, what the hell? Probably miscrafted something. And I keep going to this portal like a moron. But, yeah. the next thing I'm going to be working on, and it's going to be a pretty short video, hopefully. It's not going to be anything that's going to take me 2 or 3 episodes. Just to take a break from the city, I'm going to head over to spawn real quick. Oh, nether tunnel. Yeah, I'll show this off another time. But as we fly over here. Ooh, is that someone? Thought I'd say hi. But Ray and Benji have done their amazing job in spawn revamping it, and I don't want anything to do with the terrain generation because... Oh! No, not doing that. But as you know, I've built this wonderful river with Bitten, and... Yeah, I never completed the other side, and there's this ain't really the most detailed area of spawn, but I'm going to redo it a little bit. Of course, the pathways have been done. I don't know if these were added after the fact or something, but yeah, I'm going to kind of detail this place up, add a few trees that don't resemble that, but kind of resemble them at the same time that are smaller. Seating areas, you know, maybe put a little bit of fish in here. Are these squid named? They're not. I should name them. Get some named squid that stay here. But yeah, that should be the next video that you see. Hopefully. But, yeah. That's my little update from stream week and everything, so. Soon I'll be working on this. Bright things are going on over there right now. and it looks like it's going to be a pretty cool place to live one day. So hopefully you can find yourself a nice plot of land to go and live on one day. At least once it's open. Don't build there early, please. But it looks like we're going to have a pretty stylish studio coming up here in the near future. So stay tuned for upcoming episodes. Now, it's time to go over down to Texas, where the Beamen G series is being recorded at the moment. And you're going to get a little bit of an extra video here of some of the upgrades done to the cop car. Now, I know you may not know a lot about cars and everything like that, but try to follow along, and maybe some of it will make sense, or maybe some of it won't. But stay tuned for that episode if you want to see that car getting jumped off of a dock, because that's going to be really, really fun. Well, looky there, everybody. There's your little update from the project series of BeamNG. Cars looks like it's going to be very fun. And hopeful about that competition series it looks like is coming soon. But for now, as you can tell, our little cozy show here is coming to an end. And as you know, we always end off the show with a little bit of a sneak peek of a monthly show, Whispering Pines. And this week they are showing Lord Huron, and they're going to be performing their little new single, Moonsong. So after this commercial break, you'll get a little snippet of what's going to be coming up here in a few weeks. So we'll be right back before the end of the show. Now, what did you think of that little snippet right there? Looks like it's going to be a fun little show next week on the Whispering Pines. Go check them out. Tubbs Tarbell, always a great host. But we got a few more commercials for y'all, and then we'll be right back with the end of the show here.
Yeah. Yeah, they've taken off a lot. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, they're kind of scared. They think that you think that you truly have that 250 diamonds in that case.
I'm hoping I do.
This is their best offer yet. They really want it. They want your case for 85 diamonds. No question to you. Deal or no deal?
That is a good offer. I'm sorry, it's too no deal.
Ooh,
oh, it's our deal.
Goss is going for the millionaire.
Ooh, Baker's not out.
Goss going for, I'm never mining diamonds ever again. For Steph.
All right, you have two cases to open.
Try 24.
24. No, it's funnier than 23.
29. 24. 69. 32. 69. Wow. Jeez. Mature stuff here on Project Nebula.
You know how it is.
How he's so professional, place. He's a funny guy.
I've never said an unfunny thing in my life.
But you just are unfunny. It's okay.
All right, in that case.
Well, do you want to know what's in this chest?
Yeah,
yes.
I think we all do. We anticipation is killing us.
Gotta kill you!
Well, all right, everybody. Continuing where we left off here. You know, it seems like this week is going to be pretty interesting. You know, we got the great video of the BeamNG roadkill cop car returning for the first time in a little while, and it's going to be a pretty interesting process to see. You know, it's going to be jumped, it's going to be made into a little bit weaker of a car, but at the same time, you know, I think it's going to be a lot better. So, that is it for this episode, for your weekly little channel update. And, yeah, hopefully you guys have enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.